we are going to deal with the input box. Basically, what is the difference between a message box and an input box? Message box gives the message to the user, and maybe when it wants to get the response of the user, it will get through only the buttons which are there, like yes, no, cancel and all those. What is an input box here? Input box basically gets the input from the user, and then what you can do, you can try to use or manipulate that information into your code, right? So I've made quick notes over here. Input box, now again there are two types of input box. Why? One which is there in the VBA library, the other which is there in the Excel library. So we are going to see both of them has its own advantages, disadvantages, and this features are almost the same. We have to capture user's input. Always it returns a string. So basically, if you write the result of the input box to a cell, suppose if you are taking the name of the user from in the input box and you want to get that name into a cell in the Excel, so that can be done basically when you write the name. So it's a text type data string. So what it does, it returns the text type data string in the cell, in the Excel cell. If you write a number, maybe 4, 5, 6, any number, then that number as a number data type will be returned in the cell. So Excel will automatically convert the answer to the correct data type and will return it to the cell. You can use the conversions function to convert the answer in whatever way you want. Suppose if you want only the text data type, right, but the user maybe is writing a number, so in that number also maybe you want to deal with in form of a text. So you can use the conversion functions. We have seen string conversions, str convert function, which we have seen in our previous videos. So that can also be done when you want to convert a particular data type into a particular different data type, right? This was the VBA input box which I was talking about. The next is the Excel input box. So in the Excel input box, the advantages of using the Excel input box is that it can take any data type. So it is not restricted to a string. It can take a boolean, it can take a date, anything. So it is not restricted. The next thing is that it performs automatic validation. Now what is this? Suppose if you write something wrong in your input box, maybe you were just asked to write a number, but then you wrote a text. So you will get an automatic display alert from the Excel asking you that you have written something wrong, just correct it. Or maybe you were supposed to write just the date, or maybe cell references. Only these were the things which maybe you were asked to do. So and you have written something else. So what it does, it will give you an error message box so that you can change your input. The next thing, you can select the ranges. So what do I mean by this? Suppose you want to, as an input, you want to give a cell address, or you want to select a particular cell or different cells. That can only be done in the Excel input box. This cannot be done in the VBA Excel. Now, there are different codes for this. Suppose 0 is for formula. So if you write the code 0, it will only take input of a formula, nothing else. If you write 1, so it basically what is doing, you can just specify the data type of the input, and it is not restricted to a string. You can specify it to be a boolean, so it will only take a yes or no, true false for an answer, nothing else. Range, so it will only take basically the selected range, nothing else. So this is how, and maybe you want number and the string also together. So what you can do is, you can give an answer, you can write in the code 3. So 3 means 1 plus 2, number and a string. So this can also be done. So moving on directly to the Excel, we'll see in here, in the input box, I'll give you 2-3 quick examples. So the very first is using the VBA input box, right? So let me just say, I want to maybe write a subheading over here. So in that subheading, maybe I just want to ask the user what subheading the user wants to give. So let me just, so when what you are doing is you are trying to take the response of the user and manipulate that. Maybe want to populate that in range A2. So when you are trying to take the user's input, you need a variable in which you can assign the user's response. So you need to declare the variable first. So I need to declare the variable, maybe my input box as a string. So I just want it to be a string, nothing else, because it'll always be a, basically be a string, because I'm dealing with a VBA input box. So don't forget, it gets converted into a string. So I'll write again, I'll write my input, this should be equal to VBA dot, again you can write VBA dot interaction dot input box, or what you can do is you can just simply write VBA dot input box, so that can also be done. ठीक है, that can also be done, or you can just simply write an input box, or you can just simply write an input box, both can be done, right? Both can be done. So here in the input box, either you can just simply write an input box VBA dot interaction dot input box, or VBA dot input box. All the three are the exactly same like the message box. So the first thing is the prompt. That is the message that should be there, so that it so the user knows that what exactly do you want as an input. So I'll write, please give a subtitle, and then a comma, and then it asks for a title. So title can be maybe subtitle itself, subtitle question mark, and you just simply close your bracket. So again, it will take the input of the user and it will store it in my INB. Now in my INB, I want this to appear in here range A2. So I will say that range A2 should contain my INB, right? Let me just run this and see what happens, if it runs properly or not. So I'll just click on the run, and it says, okay, so I wrote this wrong. Please, I need to change this. Please give a subtitle. So maybe I write input box simple code. And I just click on the OK, and you get the simple code over here. So I need to change this first of all. Also, now maybe you want this to be in a proper case, like you want the headings to be, the first letter of each word to be in caps lock, or maybe you want the entire thing to be in caps. So all those features, when you want to, which was there in my PPT, as to when you want to manipulate your string or your input, your answer, you can use the conversion functions to convert the answer in the way you want it to look like. So if I want it to be in a proper case, so again, if you all remember, for the proper function we used worksheet functions. So I'll use worksheet functions. I'll write, before that I'll just write applications dot worksheet functions, application dot worksheet function dot proper, and within that I will write my INB. Okay, so basically what I'm trying to do is I'm just trying to change the input of the user, whatever the input is, into a proper case. So now let me just hit run and see what happens. So you get please give a subtitle. So now I can just give a subtitle as, maybe I can give it as actuators, and then I can click on OK. So you get an actuators, and you can see it is in a proper case. Also, again, if you just click on the run and you get this, give please give a subtitle, and in this maybe you just simply do not write anything and just click on cancel or OK. So it simply removes the existing subtitle which is there. If you do not want this to happen, if suppose you click on the cancel and it gets away, everything goes away, you do not want this to happen, then what do you do? is that it removes your text, right? So what do? You can just say that if my input is, if my input is blank, then simply exit the sub. Do not do anything else. So if this is blank, if the input is blank, then simply exit the sub. So again, I'll just give Shivangi Agarwal and I hit OK. So my name is there with proper case. Again, when I hit on run and I click on cancel, nothing is gone, because obviously if it's a blank, it will just simply exit the sub. So this was a simple case which we have done.